We're going to look at electricity now, and electricity is moving charges. In wires, it's the electrons that move. What I have here is an old-fashioned galvanometer, okay? It will measure voltage, okay? And voltage is caused by moving electrons. Here I just have, just to demonstrate this, I have a regular old battery here, and I'll put it on, and we can see we have 1.5 volts. And that's pretty standard in a battery. How batteries move electrons is a little bit different. We'll just take a look at that later on. Right now, I'll take a look at how generally most commercially available electricity is produced. Let me do a little change into our galvanometer so it will measure, because I can't make that much electricity. What I have here is a big magnet, okay? And here I have insulated copper wire that's coiled up in a circle, as you can see. And I'm going to hook it up to my galvanometer. But before I do that, we'll hook it up. And I'm going to move it around, and nothing much is happening, okay? But now, watch what happens when I move it through the magnet. I am making electricity. The magnetic field produced by the magnet can interact with the electrons in this copper coil and turn the physical motion of the copper coil to the physical motion of electrons, which we call electricity. And this is how most electricity is made in hydroelectric power. The water flowing through the dam pushes a copper coil through a magnetic field, and that produces electricity. So we're taking the energy of stored energy of water behind the dam and turning it into moving electrons, moving water to moving electrons. In windmills, it's moving wind. The windmill turns the motion of the wind into the motion of a copper coil through a magnetic field. In natural gas, coal, and nuclear plants, what they're doing is producing high pressure steam, and that high pressure steam ends up moving the copper coil through a magnetic field. And even in your car, you have a thing called an alternator, and that takes the motion of your car. It's one of those things hooked up to one of the belts under the hood, and it turns the motion of your car into electricity, which powers all the things you use in your car. And you can even see an interesting little gizmo. This is a hand-powered flashlight. And what we have here is, in this case, this is a magnet right here. And you can see the copper coils here. In this case, the magnet moves. It doesn't make any difference what moves, the magnet or the copper coils. And in fact, way back in the old days, between when we listened to things called albums, you had a phonographic needle connected to a cartridge. And there was a big debate, which was better, if the coil moved, a moving coil, or a moving magnet. And now that debate's really irrelevant. And that's how most electricity is made, except for solar power. Solar power is made an entirely different way with solar cells, and that's not a topic for today.